All right, let's bring in Maine Senator Angus King, one of the members of the Intelligence Committee who will be questioning Attorney General Sessions. Senator King is an independent from Maine, but caucuses with the Democrats. Senator, good morning to you.
Good morning, Savannah.
Sir, I'm sure you've heard this report that a friend and confidant of President Trump has said that he is considering firing the special counsel, Bob Mueller. Would that concern you? Does that report concern you?
Well, it does, but I think first the mechanics are important. The president cannot fire Bob Mueller. He must request that the acting attorney general do so, and then the acting attorney general has to use his discretion as to whether or not to take that action.
And if he did so?
And if he fired him, then I think it would be a huge mistake. This is an administration that keeps saying they want to get this over with, they want to put it behind them. And if they want to put it behind them, the best way is to let the investigation, to cooperate in the investigation, and let it take its course. If there's nothing there, as the president keeps asserting, then why do you keep impeding it by threatening anyway, in this case, or somebody threatened, to fire the current special counsel. I just think if we want to get it over with, let's follow through and get this thing done.
Would there conceivably be grounds? I think the argument on the president's side of it would be along the lines of conflict of interest. James Comey, the former FBI director, has a long history with former Director Mueller. And Comey went out of his way, I counted five or six times in his testimony last week, where he heaped praise upon Director Mueller. Is there a potential conflict? Does the president have an argument there?
Well, everybody heaped praise on former Director Mueller. Newt Gingrich said he was a superb choice, impeccable reputation. That was a month ago. He's changed in the last day or so. But everybody in Washington respects Bob Mueller. He's a career professional, former head of the FBI, a really outstanding individual. So I think it would be hard to argue that somehow he's suddenly looks like he's biased. Of course he knows Jim Comey because he was the former director before Comey.
Let's talk about the Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, who will be before your committee today. What is your number one question for him? Do you think he has some explaining to do?
Well, I think there are two main questions, and you hit it on the head, Savannah, in your opening. Number one is, what contacts, if any, did he have with the Russians before the election when he was a campaign surrogate for Donald Trump? And secondly, what role, if any, did he have in the firing of James Comey at a time when he was supposedly recused from the entire Russian investigation? The president himself said the Russia thing was on his mind when he fired Comey, so should Jeff Sessions have been involved in that decision? So those are two main areas, but I know that there are going to be many other questions. But I think those are two of the areas that we're going to be looking into and asking, giving Jeff Sessions a chance to give his side of the story.
And very, very quickly, sir, because I'm out of time, the president has said he would be willing 100% to testify under oath. Would you like to see him before your committee? Would that even be possible?
I don't think that's a good precedent to bring a president before Congress under oath. I just think that would be bad for the country in the long run. It's just not the way we do things. And I think we're going to get to the bottom of this. But the best thing, rather than testify under oath, is for the president to tell his people to talk freely, to not exert executive privilege, and let's get all the facts out, and then we can try to get through this very, very important investigation.
Senator King, it's good to have you with us this morning, sir. Thank